My name is Thorsten Kretschmer. I'm from Germany. I come from a little town from East Germany, which is famous for his artists from Otto Dix. And I now come from this town myself. And this town is called Gera. Also famous for the Simson Brunnen and the Küchengarten. But I don't want to tell anything more about it, because tonight we would like to present Entschlossenheit, but tonight we want to present it as a spoken word. And this is going to be presented in my German language. And I just want to explain why I choose to write Entschlossenheit in German, because I wanted to expose the profound differences between the English and German language. I will be accommodated by tenor Corman Stewart. Welcome, tenor Corman Stewart, who is a very well-known abstract dancer, and he will do the translation for you by speaking body language. Okay. Entschlossenheit, Zuversichtlichkeit, Gelassenheit, Vergangenheit, Freiheit, Schlaflosigkeit, Eigenständigkeit, Vergesslichkeit, Vielschichtigkeit, Gesundheit, Sozialverträglichkeit, Zufriedenheit, Einsamkeit, Wirtschaftlichkeit. Vergesslichkeit, Vielschichtigkeit, Pünktlichkeit, Unzulänglichkeit, Verbraucherfreundlichkeit, Gemütlichkeit, Zuversichtlichkeit, Gelassenheit, Köstlichkeit, Zuversichtlichkeit, Süßigkeit, Großzügigkeit, Besonnenheit, Bequemlichkeit, Schaulustigkeit, Gleichgültigkeit, Hinterhältigkeit, Arbeitslosigkeit, Gastigkeit, Übelkeit, Dämlichkeit, Dunkelheit, Verwundbarkeit, Voreingenommenheit, Feindseligkeit, Apartheid, Einfältigkeit, Geizigkeit, Überlegenheit, Lächerlichkeit, Unzulänglichkeit, Verbraucherfreundlichkeit, Unverschämtheit, Zärtlichkeit, Männlichkeit, Fruchtbarkeit, Keuschheit, Gefügigkeit, Besonnenheit. Thank you.
So we wanted to ask you just a couple of questions, or just, you know, if you have a moment. Thank you so much for performing for us tonight. And how did you begin to work together?
Well, Tenor Corman Stewart and I, first of all, when I wrote the lyrics and I performed it for the first time, we got no response at all. And I thought, I must be doing something wrong. So I think we had to add something. And I thought, Tenor Corman, can you do something? And he said yes. So that's how we started.
That's great. Do you have anything you want to add to that at all? Or?
I had no idea what I was getting into at first, and it's like a little snowball that got bigger and bigger.
So I wanted to tell everybody that there are other mixes of this song, of this piece. Actually, is all of the work you do actually from this one piece?
Basically, the whole project that we have created, which is called Entschlossenheit, evolves only around one song. And in order to really fill a CD and DVD, which we have, which I just want to show very quickly here, we had to create some kind of remixes. And you can find pieces like Entschlossenheit, Dunkelheit, you can also find Vielschichtigkeit, so everything you find on this CD and DVD. And we also have it accommodated with the DVD, which you have seen, this little piece of Dunkelheit. Of course, we also have kind of like the music video from Entschlossenheit, the song, where I'm going to sing my spoken word. And of course, we have also a little look behind the scene of the making of the video, of course.
I highly recommend this CD and DVD set, which are going to be on sale in the back. It's great, and this piece is just part of the CD. The piece Dunkelheit is really interesting, and it's there's a lot of graphics and other artwork on it that and also the performance is very interesting, and also. The making of, I think, is sort of important to the project. I think that if you see the making of this, there's some great scene. There's a great scene where these two are interviewing the potential dancers, and it's really wonderful.
Do you have outtakes on it, like bloopers? Because I like those, like they're funny.
You're gonna love it.
Okay, good. But I have to ask you guys, what is the future of art? I mean, you seem very futuristic and future romp, you know.
I was hoping that you would ask me this question. And I want to continue from what you have mentioned before, and actually what also Carla said. I'm also afraid of the, what was it, cellulitis?
Yeah.
Cellulitis? I have to apologize, my English is sometimes not that good. Of course, we're all afraid of this, and I actually, last time when I went out and went to Safeway, on the checkout line, I saw the Inquirer and the National Globe, and I felt really appealed to this picture they had, and it was, I think, some woman that just brushed her hair, and it was former Catwoman, and how she looks today. And I was stunned by this picture, because when she did this, her whole face was going backwards too. And it was scary, and was like, I have to buy that. I have to buy the Inquirer and see what is all behind that. And yes, and so I read that, of course, she had multiple plastic surgeries. She did everything to stay beautiful, of course. What she has become now is something that, I mean, she is real. I mean, I have something seen similar only like in, what was it, something comparison, what I saw similar to her was probably in Dawn of the Dead or something. But it was mass, but she is real. And I kind of think, what I can tell you is, go to Safeway or go even to Albertson. I'm sure they also have that too. To buy the National Enquirer and see how those people up there live, how they look, and how they transform themselves into something else. And I think that's going to be the future of art.